Right, time for my next review walk around. It's upgrade time. The last quick chat was about the old VL Intruder. I've moved up obviously now, and I've picked up the beast of all beasts, which if you haven't watched my 5 million other videos, is the Suzuki 2015 model Boulevard M109R Boss Edition. So I thought I'd throw up a couple of my thoughts, pros and cons, I guess, about the bike. I've done a few mods. It's not stock, but I won't go into what I've changed on the bike too much, because you can find them in all my other videos. So basically, what can I say about it? It's rock and roll. It's 1800 cc's of pure madness. I guess that's the best way to start. I think 1800 cc's pretty much explains the rest of the story. It's a monster. It goes like a bat out of hell, and it's a hell of a lot of fun. I might just start with the back of the bike and work my way through the things I like. Look, it's got a massive rear tire. I think it's 240 or something like that. I don't, not 100% sure. I think you can go up to a 260, 280 without actually having to change the rim. But anyway, I've tidied up the back end there and everything. But nice slick look at the back. Probably look a little bit better if you dropped it down a bit. The exhaust, I'll play to Freedom Performance short curve or sharp curve exhaust. I've got a video on that one. But if you stick to the end of this video, I'll put a bit of a sound bite at the end of the exhaust firing up. Put some, engine bars or whatever on there, and some different pegs. But basically, look, it's just a couple of aesthetic things that I've changed to make it mine. But yeah, look, this Boulevard sort of speaks for itself. It's a unique cruiser. It's sort of one of a kind. I was a bit wary when I bought it, when I first started riding. I still am now, obviously. You got to respect the bike. But I saw this and I couldn't, aesthetically, I just couldn't find another bike that I liked. And then once I got it, I guess it met all my expectations. There's not really anything that I don't like about it. It's such a comfortable ride. I think it gets to 0 to 30 in the same as a Porsche Spyder or something like that. It's some ridiculous acceleration this thing has, which is great, but it's smooth all the way through the years. Yeah, you sit down in that seat there, you could almost, not that I recommend it, but fall asleep. It's that comfortable. For me, for my height, 174 centimeters, the handlebars, they're in the right position. I don't think I'm going to have to change anything. I'm quite comfortable riding this bike. I thought I was going to be too small, but it's almost like it was custom made for me. I don't know, maybe because I like it so much. Headlights are right, pretty dim, unless you put it on high beam, that's fine. It did come with silver blinkers. I painted them matte black to match the rest, but again, that's just aesthetics. But like, ride wise, the brakes are fantastic. It'll stop you on a dime. It'll start in a second, and you know, it's just, there's really no issues ride wise. Whether it be, I guess, comfort, acceleration, stopping power, they all get A's in my book. We've also, I guess we've got to talk about fuel economy. It's probably not the best. Look, I've filled up every 250 kilometres. It's a 19 litre tank. I think I could probably get a lot more out of it. I just haven't, I don't trust the fuel gauge. I'll drive 250 kilometres and it will drop down one square, but the tank's just about empty when I look inside it. I'm not 100% sure what's going on there. So probably fuel management, I'm still getting used to it, so I can't really make a judgment call there in regards to how accurate the gauge is. The only other con that I would have is that I would have this, and I think everyone says it, the Speedo up here where we've got the gear indicator and your rev, your taco. This to me is not that important. You can hear what gear the bike's in. That if you really wanted to look, yeah, put it down here. But put the speed up here. If you're flying along at say 170 kilometers, I mean, you wouldn't ever go 170 kilometers an hour, but you're streamlined, you've got your head down, you're crouched down. You don't want to then be putting your head down to look down at this for your speed, because you want to know how fast you're going. But anyway, but you know what, other than that, being in the wrong place, in my opinion, and what I've heard a lot of other people, I can't really say anything bad about this bike. It's heavy, but it feels right. It's not that hard to maneuver in car parks and at slow speed once you get used to it, because the riding position is so low. You can maneuver it around. Obviously, don't park it face first down a hill to a wall. You'll never get it out. So that'd be interesting. But look, other than that, you can wheel it around. I'm not the strongest bloke in the world, but I've got little chicken legs, but I can still push it around. It's good. Cornering, absolutely fine. The only time that I've bottomed out on this thing is going around roundabouts, and there's only a little, these are aftermarket pegs as well, but going around roundabouts, I think that's more me being an unco rather than the bike. But I've taken it up to the mountains and through the cane fields and the rest of it, and really got a swing into it, and it loves the corners. I mean, we've got so much travel space on that tyre. But yeah, so cornering, slow manoeuvring, acceleration, stopping, it's great. I might put a proviso that I don't have much experience on motorbikes. I've only rode a few, ridden a few. So that's a couple of dirt bikes, the VL Intruder, that Ninja sitting over there, 300 or whatever that is, and this beast. But I can definitely say this is the best. It's got power to boot. It's a bike that I think that I'll definitely be sticking with for a long time, if not forever. It's got everything I need. It's up there at the top peak performance echelon for a cruiser. So hey, I'm happy. If you're thinking of one, I reckon you get down to your local dealer and you take one for a test drive ASAP. Just a big shout out to everyone that subscribed. I think I've hit somewhere around the 3,000 mark. Pretty crazy. So look, I don't think I have to tell you to subscribe, but like and leave a comment, say g'day, and I'll catch you all next time. Enjoy the ride.